Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about page layouts. So I did do this video a number of years ago on the channel and I've significantly upgraded my voice or my video. And I want to redo this video so then it is a little easier to listen to and watch. So let's go ahead and hop into opportunities and I'll show you what I mean about page layouts. So this is currently, we're on page layout where you have the details of the opportunity. The page layout dictates what you see, the different fields that you see, where you see them, the different aspects of the page layout. It also dictates the related lists as well, and all these different aspects. So there are different things that you can do to a page layout to make it look better, make it look cleaner. If you have loads of fields, you can bucket them or group them so then they kind of accordion down like the related list does. You can add more buttons and links and actions as well. But let's talk a little bit more about page layouts in general. So page layouts, they work together with record types and with profiles. So depending on the record type and the profile, it'll dictate the different fields that you see and where you see them at. So let's go ahead and hop into the object here and go to page layouts. I'm going to go to page layout assignment and you can see this work a little bit more. So we currently have four different page layouts on the opportunity. We have the regular one, we have sales support and marketing. So anything for marketing would be with the marketing layout. Anything for sales would typically be the sales layout. Opportunity or support would be support. And the regular opportunity layout would be for anyone who doesn't necessarily fall into each of these different categories. So now one thing that we don't see is the record type because there's only one record type. So then it just says page layout, but typically up here would be the record type. And if we had two, there'd be two different columns and three different columns. And then for each of these, then you'd be able to parse it out individually by each profile and record type. So let's say this is the record type one. So we would be able to, if it's the analytics cloud and they are on the first record type, then they would say the opportunity layout. Same for marketing. Let's say we had the marketing profile and then the record type was marketing. And then we also had a sales one. For the profile, you could dictate. So when they're on the marketing record type, they'll see the marketing layout. But when they're on the sales record type, then they would see the sales layout. So that's kind of an overview of how those two work together. Let's go back to page layouts and I will show you. If you want to create a new page layout, actually, you would go here and then it would just be a blank slate and you would be able to add the different fields that you want to add. But for now, we're just going to modify this one. So as you can see here, we have our opportunity information. One thing I do like to do is I like to make this header visible. And to do that, we would just do detail information. So now you can accordion it and parse out the information by the different things. So like we'll have system integration or information be a detail and you can accordion it on and off. Additional information you can accordion on and off. And you could name this to be order information as well. So let's say we wanted to remove next step. To do that, we could just move it out or we could come here and hit the little minus and it would remove that field. If we wanted to add something like the forecast category, we would go ahead and just drag and drop there. So that's kind of a basic of fields. Usually you'll have the fields that are available to you per the opportunity record, excuse me, per the object and what fields are available on the object. So then you have buttons. You can go ahead and change the different buttons that you have, any custom links, such as delivery status, quick actions, mobile actions. If you're going to cross over and also do mobile with this, you'd be able to do that. You can do expanded lookups. And then we have related lists. So related lists are the things that are on the sides and they are going to be related records to the record that you are currently on. So this would be things like opportunities, products, orders. You can see files here, groups. If you're using opportunity teams, it would include opportunity teams. And this just allows you to see records that are on a different object but are still related to the record. So then you can get the information without having to click around and figure out where things are. I'm going to add service appointments down underneath open activities. And these are just, again, drag and drops. You can remove it if you would like that there. Competitors, I'm going to remove that. And we can either quick save. So quick save saves it but keeps you on this page. So then you can keep doing it. It's good to do that every few minutes. And save will take you back to the list of those. Here, we are also able to move a field in Salesforce. This is one of my more popular videos on the channel, is that we can move a field around, depending on if you want to have it be closer in sight or maybe a little farther down where you have to go searching for it. You can change this to be a one column or a two column. And for those of you that like to tab to move to the next field, then you could do it as top down or left right. Personally, I like left right. So I'm going to do that there. And I will hit save. And there you go. That is how you kind of go forward changing things on your layout. If we were to create a new page layout, we would do this from a similar layout. And you would hit save, and then it would just copy it, and you would be able to go back and change the different things. Maybe you want this to be for external partners to see your opportunities and see very limited information about the different opportunities that you have. Nice quick save. Go back to page layouts. One thing about page layouts, though, is that it does take quite a bit of time for them to update. So if we were to go over to our opportunity and refresh, it may or may not show the changes that we have made quite yet. Sometimes it takes up to 10 minutes for these things to change. Service appointments is here, like we added on for the related list, so that is good to know. And we can see these little accordion bars here that help you to kind of gauge which information and streamline maybe the visual process of Salesforce on the page layout. So if you have any questions, be sure to leave them down below. Be sure to like and subscribe. Check out the courses down below and subscribe to the email list at salesforceemily.com. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.